Greetings to all. Come on, look at the bird. You are seeing beautiful picture. Here is a bird nest, mother bird, big bird, and two younger birds. So here we are seeing that mother bird is feeding their younger birds. Especially the bird supplies food into the mouths of the younger ones. It happens in case of every birds. Every mother bird go very distant places and it brings some food there, it picks up some food and come back to their nests, and it supply the taken food into the mouths of the younger birds. As the time goes on, the younger birds try to fly. After some years, they will fly into the air. Then the mother bird feels happy. But in case of some species of birds, some types of birds, the younger ones, though they have been supplying food, after some time they won't try to fly. The mother bird go very far distances, it picks up food there and it come back to the nest, it supplies food into the mouths of the younger ones. It happens, but they won't try to fly. Then in some types of birds, mother birds, they think a plan. Then they bring some thorny twigs and they keep that thorny twigs inside the nest. It keeps the thorny twigs where the younger ones take rest and sleep. After taking food, the younger birds generally take rest and sleep. After the mother bird kept these thorny twigs inside the nest, when the younger birds try to rest and sleep, they feel pain. Because of the thorny twigs under them, actually they don't know that they are lying on the thorny twigs. Because of those thorns, the younger ones feel pain. When they feel pain, to escape from the pain, they try to fly. They try to fly at that time, try to fly at once. They fly in the air. Then the mother birds feel happy. It happens, it occurs especially in some types of birds. So this is how mother birds make their younger ones learn how to fly. So it happens in especially some types of birds. Okay, by the way, my name is Gyara Nageshwar Rao. I am a physical science teacher. I have been working in Municipal Boys High School, Narasaraopet. I recently got a TOMS training, Integrated Communication Skills Training Program. So here, what is TOMS? TOMS is nothing but a transformation of municipal schools. It's a very wonderful program designed by Andhra Pradesh government. Under this TOMS program, the government is going to boost all our municipal schools. It's going to develop all our municipal schools competing with the corporate schools. That is why government framed TOMS program with the help of prestigious Cambridge University. With the help of Cambridge University, government framed TOMS program. Under this TOMS program, all the municipal teachers are going to be trained in a phased manner. We have already completed 3 phases. 4th phase is going on. 28th onwards, we are going to attend offline classes. So, under this TOMS program, government is giving communication skills training. And at the same time, government is going to establish e-curriculum content creation studios in 3 places in the state. What they are? Vizag, Vijayawada and Kurnool. In 3 centers, government is going to establish e-curriculum content creation studios. At the same time, career guidance program also is being arranged for all the municipal students. And the government is going to conduct international Olympiad for only municipal school students soon. And it's going to establish integrated international labs in all the district headquarters in 3 subjects. They are mathematics, English and sciences. So these are the programs that are framed by the government under the program TOMS terms. So regarding to this, we are being trained by well-trained persons from the Cambridge University. I already took the training program, and here we are going to receive mainly how to communicate in English fluently. As we all know, our schools are going to be converted into English medium schools. That's why government framed this program. On communication, we are going to be trained in the training classes. If we see, communication is a process of meaningful interaction among human beings. It's told by M.C. Fairland. So communication is nothing but meaningful interaction between one person and the other person. So this is the communication skills program. There, well trainers will come and train you in a well manner. But what the common problem in this training program is fear to speak in English. When trainer comes to you and asks, speak something in English, we feel fearsome. We feel fearsome because we create fear. When we create fear, we know how to eradicate it. Try to speak. Listen to me carefully. Speaking is the ability must be performed by our mouth. A hand does it work. A leg does it work. Like that, all the organs of our body do their function. With the coordination of all the body parts, we are able to do our work. So like that, speaking is a physical activity. Just we have to speak with our mouth. Until and unless you don't open our mouth, you never speak English. I am telling you that speak, whether it is correct or incorrect, it is another issue. First you try to speak. When you try to speak and practice every day, after some days you will speak better English. So that is, speak first and speak best. So for this, I am going to bring you useful videos regarding to the easy understanding of this ICS training program. For this, I am going to bring you some videos. Regarding to this, I have a YouTube channel. My channel name is Referit. And on this Referit channel, you can avail all these videos. And for the continuous videos, you have to subscribe it. I appeal you to subscribe this Referit channel, and I am going to explain all the chapters every day, and I will explain you the model test papers regarding to the exam at the end of the training program. Okay, subscribe it and don't forget to comment. Thank you, one and all.